countries are eliminating diseases all over the world.
In fact, in the last 5 years alone, 44 eliminations have been confirmed by WHO.
There's one disease that, because of a global effort, no one can get anymore. Do you know which one it is? If yes, please write it down in the comments and we'll talk about it in this episode. We are talking about disease elimination today. What does it take to eliminate a disease on the ground? And what needs to happen before WHO can confirm that a disease has been eliminated? We are talking to Dr. Jerome Solomon. Welcome, Jerome.
Thank you.
What are these diseases that have been eliminated in the past 5 years?
So many diseases, like tropical diseases, have already been eliminated. 50 countries, for example, already eliminated at least one neglected tropical disease. So that's huge success, and because it's a very heavy burden for the population. Malaria, 45 countries already eliminated malaria, thanks to all the tools that are available. Vector controls, insecticides, bed nets, chemoprophylaxis, treatment, and now we have two vaccines to protect children. Important point, how we want to protect, for example, pregnant women, transmit infections to their babies of HIV, hepatitis B, syphilis. We are working with many countries to eliminate this vertical transmission of very important disease. And something that maybe a lot of women don't know, we can prevent cervical cancer thanks to vaccination. You know, we have a lot of examples, and we are very, very hopeful that we will eliminate 32 diseases in the next decades.
So what needs to happen on the ground for a disease to be eliminated and for WHO to confirm that it has indeed been eliminated?
When we say elimination, it's eliminating a disease as a public health problem, as a public health concern in a region or in a country. It's a huge work because we need a strong political commitment coming from the head of state and ministries, of course. WHO is helping a lot in terms of technical assistance and guidance. We are working, for example, with education department, with agriculture department, with environment, because it's a global health, it's a one health approach. And then the local level is the most important one, because we need to have the villages, the chiefs of the villages, the communities involved and engaged. We need also NGOs, we need the strong voice of people with lived experience, we need the young people to be also very committed to explain, to share their experience, to adapt the tools to all the populations, because we need to work without any stigma, without any discrimination, and we need all the populations to be fully engaged. We have a very important report to WHO, and then WHO can certify. Take a very concrete example, the polio eradication campaign. We need all the populations to be vaccinated. So it's very important because we are very close to eradication of polio. We have to keep in mind that the efforts should be strong and we never stop surveillance and having in mind that this virus could be back.
So when we eliminate polio, does that mean it'll be like smallpox, gone forever?
So it's important to remind that smallpox is the only human disease that has been eradicated. It was in 1980, so it was 45 years ago, and we are still trying to eradicate a second disease, maybe Guinea worm or polio.
Jerome, what can individuals and communities do to support disease elimination?
They can do a lot. Sometimes we could say, well, neglected tropical disease or some of these diseases, I'm not concerned because I am very far away, I'm 1,000 kilometers away, I'm living in a rich country that is not affected, which is a wrong idea, because it's like a fire. You could say, well, the fire is far away from my house, I don't need to call the firemen. But in fact, you could wait and then the fire will affect your house. So having this global behavior, meaning, you know, we are all committed, we are all affected. I think even individuals in rich countries could really convince their government that we need a global health architecture, that we need a global health surveillance, and we need a global commitment to fight communicable disease and tropical diseases. You can be strong ambassadors of public health, sharing messages, teaching people, reaching the unreachable of your communities. We are living on a very small planet. It's a small village. We all have a role to play.
Thank you, Jerome. That was Science in 5 today. Until next time, then, stay safe, stay healthy, and stick with science.